The Reproductive Healthcare Bill 2019 by Nakuru Senator Susan Kihika seems to have rattled members of the clergy. And on Sunday morning, the evangelical members of Kenya were up in arms, terming the bill extreme, describing it as an abomination. The chairman of the Kenya Evangelical Alliance, Bishop Kefa Umae, says the bill's connotations are not only problematic but ungodly.
It legalizes the killing of disabled and mentally retarded persons in their preborn stages of life. Every unborn child has a right to life.
The church leaders citing, among other things, that the bill normalizes underage sex, encourages same-sex marriages, and teaches that sex is for pleasure, among other things.
And goes further to open the door for children between the ages of 10 to 17 that they should receive contraceptives, safe abortion, and comprehensive sexuality education, which teaches that sex is for pleasure and that sexual pleasure is a right. If we allow sexual pleasure to be taught as a right, what happens when one wants a pleasure and there is no consenting partner of the opposite sex?
The main clauses in the bill include access to family planning, assisted reproduction, safe motherhood, termination of pregnancy and reproductive health of adolescents. Senator Kihika says the clergy has either misinterpreted the bill or not read it at all.
That is misinformation, that is malice, and that is just intended to whip the emotions of the public, because there is not such a thing in the bill. It is a reproductive healthcare bill, not an abortion bill, not encouraging rape, not encouraging underage sex, and definitely not encouraging same-sex marriage.
The senator argues the formation of the bill involved even church leaders from the onset, and the bill now in its third reading at the Senate is only supplementing tenets under the current constitution. She says the bill is essential in the education syllabus in carrying information on reproductive health.
So what the bill seeks to address is have in a school setting, in age-appropriate adolescent healthcare services, where there's like counseling on abstinence, like we're talking about. If it's not on abstinence and they're already engaging, then they're also counseled on the effects of, say, abortion. And I know there was a big issue on consequences of unsafe abortion. That was one part of the bill, on the bill. And we've had people complain about the unsafe part of
abortion.
Should
this be passed into law? Kihika says the bill will help solve the issues in reproductive health in the country for now and into the future. Makori Ongechi, Citizen TV, Nairobi.